Now, the controversial statue of the renowned Indian political and civil rights leader Mahatma Gandhi has been removed from the campus of the University of Ghana. Some students and lecturers of the university had called for the removal of the statue because of what they called his, quote, racist identity. An outline petition, an online petition was launched after some student had earlier defaced the statue in protest. It is unclear where the statue of the Indian leader has been relocated to, but sources at the University of Ghana say the sculpture has been handed over to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Joining us is Emmanuel Jivanu, is at the University of Ghana campus. He joins me on the phone now. Hello, Emmanuel. What's the latest? What's the mood on campus, I might start?
Well, as of now, the University of Ghana is currently calm. There's no much of activity because students, most of the students have finished the examination and have recessed back home after the exams. Today, at about 7 a.m., the sculpture or the statue of Mahatma Gandhi was taken off. But a while ago, I spoke to the Vice Chancellor of the University of Ghana, who confirmed to me that the personnel from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs actually came to them or came to management to have a discussion on the relocation of the sculpture or the statue of Mahatma Gandhi. And he said currently the sculpture has been taken to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. So if you come here just at the back of BAM Library where the statue was located, on the University of Ghana, it has been taken off. It's left with a foundation, just left with a foundation on which the statue was erected, and the inscription of Mahatma Gandhi's name also being taken off. So currently, this is what I'm picking, or it's happening on the University of Ghana. And initially, when people were agitating for the structure to be taken off, and later the spectacles was taken off by some students under the disguise of the in the night, actually in the night, a security guard was positioned over here. But as of now, there's nobody guarding over here after the sculpture of Mahatma Gandhi.
Jivanu, we know that you're with Dr. Obadele Kyamba of the Institute of African Studies. Let's quickly engage Dr. Kyamba now on this development. Sir, thank you so much for your time this afternoon here on the Pulse. First of all, what happened? I mean, this this debate has been going on for a while. I mean, we know that some time ago, students at the University of Ghana agitated. It didn't happen then. How come it's happening now?
So this is a good question. When the government said that they would take the statue, we were very clear that it was a move to make everything die down, because people were very incensed and angry about this. Some even took the spectacles. When I looked a few weeks ago, someone had thrown mud at this statue. So in terms of the timing, we haven't gotten any communication from the government or the university about why now. So I'm not equipped to answer that question.
Okay.
But all I can say is that I'm very happy that this is taking place right now, because what this means is a triumph of black dignity and self-respect over those who don't care about any of those things.
Well, Gandhi, you could argue about the racist bit a little, but there are several people who have referred to him, great leaders who have referred to him, that he stood for something. Does that not mean anything in this context?
It's a very good question, and this is the thing. Gandhi duped many people, many great people, as a matter of fact, because it wasn't until 99 thereabout that all of his collected writings were available. So he was writing in Hindi, he was writing in his native Gujarati, in addition to what he wrote in English, the autobiography and things of that nature. So all of these people who said, oh, wow, he's so great, you have to put him in context of who was he in relation to black people, in relation to African people. And who he was is that he was someone who fought against the Zulu. He was someone who fought for apartheid and the separation of the post office and the telegraph office there in Durban. He was someone who was called in India as the worst enemy of the Dalits by Dr. Ambedkar. So the Dalits are the black untouchables of India. So this is someone who we have to understand that even if he was great for his own people, meaning the upper caste Hindus, that he was someone who was terrible to black people throughout his entire life, both his time in South Africa, and then when he went to India, he fought tooth and nail against the aspirations of the Dalit, the black untouchables of India, which is why to even this day, black people, African people, Nigerians, Ghanaians are there, and they are beaten every day. There was a Congolese man who was beaten to death in broad daylight in India. Why? Because he gets the same treatment as the indigenous black Dalits of India. Mm. So this is something that we have to understand. There's a saying that says, if a lie takes 1,000 years to go on a journey, truth will catch up to that lie in a day. So all of these lies about Gandhi that are proliferated just because people didn't know. If you mention Nelson Mandela, if you mention Martin Luther King, if you mention Kwame Nkrumah, all these people didn't have the opportunity to research and read his words about black people, his early life and his later life, and the consistency of it. If they had that opportunity, they would have taken a different stance. But myself as a researcher, I am a research coordinator at African Studies. So I'm paid by the Ghanaian people to do research. So I'm not guessing about Gandhi. I'm not guessing about what he stood for. I've read his work. I've read all of these different collected works of Mahatma Gandhi and books on him and what Dr. Ambedkar said about him, what Gandhi and the Congress have done to the untouchable. So me, I'm very well informed. So anyone who has this information who comes to a different conclusion, it means that they don't mean well for black people. But most people just are uninformed and they don't know.
So if I get you clearly, all you're saying is that the racist part of this man you're talking about, based on the things that he wrote and his reactions to some of the things that have happened in the past, negates it. I mean, it doesn't matter what he has done. It negates every good thing that he stood for.
No, what I mean is that he did good things, if you want to call him good, for his upper caste. He said that when he wrote to the British, he said that the Indo-Aryan come of a common stock and that they are partners in the colonization of black people.
Okay.
This is what he stood for. He stood for his caste, for the Baniya caste, which is those who are the traders, which is a subgroup of the Vaishyas. Mm. So we have to, again, understand this. It's not only what he said or what he wrote. He actually was a sergeant major in a war fighting against the Zulus in which thousands and thousands of Zulu people were killed. And he wanted to get guns. He agitated to get guns, but only the British didn't consider him to be good enough to get the guns. This is how we have to understand not only the words, but his actions.
Okay.
Look at how he argued in order to separate the post office and the telegraph office there in Durban. How many people are aware that he did that? This is really, when we think about it, you can look at this, the start of institutional apartheid there in South Africa was because of Gandhi. So they could have a different entrance and wouldn't have to go through the same entrance as the Kaffir. He said that you are one degree, he said you yourself who's asking me the question, he said you are 1 degree removed from an animal. I hope you understand.
I get your point. Let's talk about
what he did for Indo-Aryan people.
Dr. Kamo, let's look at the significance of what has happened today at the University of Ghana. Now that statue is down. You're saying that it's a good thing, but what is the significance, especially at the University of Ghana, you know, for researchers like yourself, for academia, self-respect. What is the significance, and where do we go from here? Should it be replaced with something else?
So this is a very good question. Now, myself and Dr. Akiedia Chia, who is in the School of Law, it's not just me, this is a collective effort, that we've written 2 articles together with Roads Must Fall. And what this is part of a greater movement for black dignity and black self-respect throughout the world, the same as the National Anthem protest in the U.S., the same as Roads Must Fall in South Africa and Oxford, the same as the protest of the black students who are beaten and stabbed daily there in India by those who consider themselves upper caste, Indo-Aryan Hindus and things of that nature. So what we see is black self-respect is on the rise. And in addition to that, what this means is that we have more people who care about black dignity and black self-respect than those who would like to trample on our dignity and self-respect here at the university. Just the fact that we had so many signatures, even in the first weekend or 2 weeks before the government said that they were going to take the statue away, it just tells you that when people understand the issues, when you help them to understand the issues, that they will rally around those issues and they will finally strike a blow for dignity and self-respect. But we have to say our luta continua, because we don't know where the statue of Gandhi will next rear its ugly head. We have our colleagues there in Malawi who did a court injunction, because now people know. Again, no matter how long it takes, eventually the truth will catch up to the lie. So what we can say is that we're still fighting for black dignity, we're still fighting for black self-respect.
Okay.
But what this means is that the University of Ghana has struck a blow for black dignity and black self-respect throughout the world.
All right. Dr. Obadile Kambon there, he is with the Institute of African Studies. He's a researcher there. Doc, thank you so much for your time this afternoon here on The Pulse. So this is actually, if you like, ends a very long-standing conversation about bringing that statue down at the University of Ghana campus.